really excited to talk to you guys. I watched the show and it was so great and so cute.
Thank you.
We're glad you're enjoying it.
It was wonderful. My first question is for Camila. The nice thing about the show is that your character, Julia, is her own person and she has her own story, hopes, and dreams. What did you find most inspirational about Julia?
I think, God, can I say everything? I found her so inspiring. And after we wrapped, I feel like I still tried to be the person that she was on the show. She's so polite. She's so intelligent. She's just full of dreams. She's very ambitious. And I think that's something that I really aspire to be. I think I am, but she's just top notch.
She's definitely a role model, I would say.
I think she's definitely a role model, for sure. I don't consider myself a role model yet. I think I'm a very perfect human being, but I think Julia is up there for sure for me. She's, yeah.
Absolutely, I agree. Fernando, your character Memo works as comic relief, but also so much more than that. What was your favorite thing about your character and his story?
Well, my favorite thing about the character was the fact that plus size people are not being represented in media in a very positive light. And the comedy of my character doesn't come from his weight or his appearance, which is rare. So I feel very proud about playing this role with that in mind. But also getting to be the person that's always reminding people to stay positive and follow their dreams. Like, I want to be that in real life. So the fact that I get to do it through this character feels really special.
Absolutely. So this question is for the both of you. What was it like filming a show set in the 80s? Did you get all the references? What was it like bringing the 80s to life?
That's fun. I mean, the hotel was bright and colorful. The costumes were amazing. There were a lot of Mexican 80s references, you know, like that we can identify. I mean, me being Mexican, I can identify too. And like, of course, talking to the writer, sometimes they would say, oh, this character kind of reminds us of this character from this 80s movie and stuff like that. So
costumes and sets.
Mm-hmm. And it was cool because our creative team, like arts, props, costumes, they were
top notch.
And they were our age in the 80s. So we got a very authentic experience.
You talked about the hotel and how colorful it was. What was it like working on this set in comparison to other things you've worked on before?
I think the magnitude of it was all like, it was huge. I felt like I was on a Broadway show.
Yeah.
I
come from a musical theater background. And I mean, that's most of my resume, really. All my resume. This is my first TV show. All my resume. But no, it's definitely, it felt larger than life.
It felt larger than life. Hey, even the hair.
And it was larger than life, for sure.
Awesome. And so my last question for you both is, what do you hope audiences take away with them when they finish watching this first season?
To fight for their dreams, mm-hmm. to love, to have a community, to just be kind to one another.
And I think we are all hoping that the audiences see themselves on screen.
We want to be relatable in mm-hmm. some way. I think that's very important.
We believe our show is very universal. So this is not just for Latinx communities or immigrant communities. You know, this is for everybody, yeah.
Absolutely agree. I think the show was wonderful. I think it's relatable on so many different levels. And I really hope to see you guys again for a second season.
Oh, we do too. We do too.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us today.
Oh, thank you. Have a great day.